Clifford locates the site of the disaster and wreckage of the once mighty Armada. That's pretty cool. What was this? That looks neat. Sir Henry Morgan. Okay. This is the Girls of Atomic City. These are all books that my dad read. He loves books like this. So he's handing them on to me. The Untold Story of the Women Who Helped Win World War II by Denise Kiernan. At the height of World War II, Oak Ridge, Tennessee was home to 75,000 residents, consuming more electricity than New York City. But to most of the world, the town did not exist. Thousands of civilians, many of them young women from small towns across America, were recruited to this secret city, enticed by solid wages and the promise of war-ending work. Kept very much in the dark, few would ever guess the true nature of the tasks they performed each day in the hulking factories in the middle of the Appalachian Mountains. That is until the end of the war, when Oak Ridge's secret was revealed. Drawing on the voices of the women who lived it, women who are now in their 80s and 90s, the Girls of Atomic City rescues a remarkable forgotten chapter of American history from obscurity. Denise Kiernan captures the spirit of the times through these women, their pluck, their desire to contribute, and their enduring courage, combining the grand scale human drama of the worst hard time with the intimate biography and often troubling science of the immortal life of Henrietta Lacks. The Girls of Atomic City is a lasting and important addition to our country's history. Okay, so let's see. There's some more over here. Lots more. Alright, so start with this one. It's got a little bend. William McOwen. McGwen. I'm not sure how to say that. Idaho Falls. The Untold Story of America's First Nuclear Accident. That seems pretty interesting. In Idaho Falls, award-winning journalist William McGowan reveals one of American history's best-kept secrets, the first major nuclear accident in the United States was not Three Mile Island, and people died. Interesting. That looks pretty neat. This is the Lusitania. So, I could be wrong, but I think that the Lusitania is the ship that rescued the survivors from the water after the Titanic sank. And then I think it might have been also the ship that was blown up or torpedoed right before the start of World War I. But I wouldn't quote me on that. Diana Preston is the author. An epic tragedy. What does it say? On May 7th, 1915, the ocean liner Lusitania was struck by a terrifying new weapon and became a casualty of a terrible new kind of war. This account offers us a vivid picture of the event that shocked the world. a view of the heyday of the luxury liner and the first days of the modern submarine, a critical chapter in the progress of World War I, and a remarkable human drama. With first-person survivor accounts, original translations of German documents, and a cast of characters ranging from Winston Churchill and Alfred Vanderbilt to the crew of the German U-boat that torpedoed a ship full of civilians. This is a true tale of terror and tragedy, of heroism and miraculous survival. does it say where the Black Hills are? Oh, it's in Dakota Territory. Okay. Wow, look at that old western town. That's neat. And then this is the Enterprise. America's fightingest ship and the men who helped win World War II by Barrett Tillman. Bluff. 11 days in December. Day of Deceit, the truth about FDR and Pearl Harbor. Okay, this is by Robert B. Stennett with a new afterword. So, in Day of Deceit, Robert Stennett delivers the definitive final chapter on America's greatest secret and our worst military disaster, drawing on 20 years of research and access to scores of previously classified documents. Stennett proves that Pearl Harbor was not an accident, a mere failure of American intelligence, or a brilliant Japanese military coup, by showing that ample warning of the attack was on FDR's desk, and furthermore, that a plan to push Japan into war was initiated at the highest levels of the U.S. government. He ends up profoundly altering our understanding of one of the most significant events in American history. December, Christmas at the Bulge, 1944. Soldiers trying to stop the Nazis from retaking Belgium in one of the most decisive battles of World War II. While a German loudspeaker taunted, "How would you like to die for Christmas?" the Allied forces dug in, despite freezing conditions. In a medieval chapel, General George S. Patton, who needed fair weather for airborne troop support to arrive, uttered what would become a famous prayer. "Sir, you have just got to make up your mind whose side you're on." His soldiers wouldn't be home for the holidays, but as the skies cleared, they went on to win a battle and a war. In this Christmas classic, acclaimed author Stanley Weintraub explores the irony and poignancy of waging war during a season dedicated to peace on Earth. So the blind man's bluff. The untold story of American submarine espionage. Sherry Sontag and Christopher Drew with Annette Lawrence Drew. information and advantage in missions known only to a select few. Now, after 6 years of research, those missions are told in Blind Man's Bluff, a magnificent achievement in investigative reporting. It reads like a spy thriller, except everything in it is true. This is an epic of adventure, ingenuity, courage, and disaster beneath the sea. A story filled with unforgettable characters who engineered daring missions to the top to tap the enemy's underwater communications cables and to shadow Soviet submarines. It is a story of heroes and spies, of bravery and tragedy. That's pretty cool. Okay. My feet are falling asleep because I'm sitting on top of them. So this one I actually gave to my dad. Street, you know, I reckon there ain't one boy in a thousand. play Becky Thatcher in Tom Sawyer. And it was awesome. It was so fun. I absolutely loved that role. And the boy who played Tom Sawyer was one of my best friends. And he's actually since passed away. He passed away several years ago, about 7 years ago. So that's kind of hard to think about, but I definitely have fond memories of being in that play, and it was a good time. Okay. So this one I actually gave to my dad, and he's handing it back. This is Brad Meltzer and Josh Mincich, The First Conspiracy, The Secret Plot to Kill George Washington. This one is really good. In 1776, an elite group of soldiers were handpicked to serve as George Washington's bodyguards. Washington trusted and relied on them, but unbeknownst to him, some of the guards were part of a treasonous plan. In the early months of the Revolutionary War, these traitorous soldiers, along with the governor of New York and the mayor of New York City, launched a deadly scheme against the most important member of the military, George Washington himself. This is a tale of leaders, liars, counterfeiters, and jailhouse confessions, and the dangerous machinations that played out in the tumultuous days leading up to July 4th, 1776. Crusade, Paul Fussell, World War II veteran and winner of the National Book Award and the National Book Critics Circle Award, has written an unsentimental and unflinching narrative on what the Second World War was really like for the young men who fought it, peeling away the persistent layers of myth that sanitized the more brutal realities of combat. Fussell focuses on the action and human emotion triggered by the intense pressures of war, and acquaints readers with the remarkable bravery of the boy soldiers, for most were in their late teens, while deepening our awareness of their struggle. Based in large part on the author's own experience, this is a harrowing book that stands wholly apart from the vast body of World War II literature. Oh, this is the same book. This is this book. Okay. This one is brought by Brian Kilmeade and Don Yeager. Authors of Thomas Jefferson and the Tripoli Pirates. Andrew Jackson. And The Miracle of New Orleans, the battle that shaped America's destiny. Losing battles in Canada. Then British troops before they really got off the ground. Jackson needed a miracle. Few today remember the unlikely team of heroes Jackson assembled, including frontier militiamen, French-speaking Louisianans, Cherokee and Choctaw Indians, freed slaves, and even pirates, who defeated the most powerful military force in the world, as they did in their previous two bestsellers, Kilmeade and Yeager, reinvigorate our knowledge of one of America's greatest generals, who later became one of our most controversial presidents, and the brave men who fought so that America could one day stretch from sea to shining sea. That sounds good. This is like a little tiny book, a brief discourse on 18th century games by Richard Tully. Interesting. It's cards. I saw dominoes. So this one, this is the last three we're gonna do here. This is by Brian Kilmeade as well, and Don Yeager. Thomas Jefferson and the Tripoli Pirates. The forgotten war that changed American history. When Thomas Jefferson became president in 1801, America was deeply in debt, with its economy and dignity under attack. For 15 years, the new nation had tried to work with the four Muslim powers, Tripoli, Tunis, Algiers, and Morocco, whose pirates had been kidnapping American sailors for ransom. But negotiation proved impossible. Realizing it was time to stand up to the intimidation, Jefferson sent the U.S. Navy and Marines to blockade Tripoli, launching the Barbary Wars and beginning America's journey toward future superpower status. For today, remember these men and other heroes who inspired the Marine Corps hymn. From the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tripoli, we fight our country's battles in the air, on land, and sea. Thomas Jefferson and the Tripoli Pirates recaptures this forgotten war that changed American history with a real-life drama of intrigue, bravery, and battle on the high seas. Interesting. Win the desert or die in the desert. So this one is another one of those really cool covers. It's like leather. Or suede, I don't even know. A Tale of Two Cities. Charles Dickens. It is a far, far better thing that I do than I have ever done. It is a far, far better rest that I go to than I have ever known. I really like this book. I read it a couple times. It's a good one. It's basically what's happening in London and Paris during the time of the French Revolution. Okay, and then this magazine was in the box as well. It's a Time magazine. Founding Fathers. American visionaries who created a great nation. Jefferson, Franklin, Washington, Adams, Hamilton, Jay, and Madison. So this is from 2019. To read all of these. If you did like this video, don't forget to leave a like, and please do subscribe to the channel. I would love to hear from you in the comment section, and I would love to have you back in my next video.